Good morning, country people. Abenguna Saloto, this one I'm Asa Gabila, spokesperson for Scope. I want just bring one this morning a message of encouragement and hope in this time of troubled moments, seeing all the different challenges that we would go through. And also we'll get through every now and again the struggle will come against a time where we get discouragement, where we feel like I make them work. Personally, I woke up this morning feeling very discouraged, feeling very sad and downcast when you see the audios the way to go around at the moment, essentially asking the question, what's the point? The hardship is a lot, the people are suffering. We are the heat of the struggle. The leaders seem to be confused. There are issues around fighting around money, and a lot of people, if you wake up, feel very downcast, like I feel this morning. But I just feel like I just come with this message of encouragement. For me, we realize, say, nah, a very expected part of every struggle. We go through seasons and times like that. So, maybe an announced program broadcast. If you just catch a few of them are there online, we could just get a time of encouragement, encouraging one another for realizing the whole season we are going through can be expected. It happens in every struggle. Every time any person be enslaved, one free himself from slavery, we go through these challenges. So I just want to catch people that go there online. We could just encourage ourselves. Find strength in each other and find strength in the Lord. So if you're reading online briefly, just for maybe we'll get this very short conversation, if you just share, encourage other people to try for address the issue the way they don't happen with struggle. Particularly, the one thing I want to address now that audio where this way circulated for the last couple of days, and the sentiment only be arisen again and again. You know, say leaders and be fight over money, people then be die, people then be suffer. We talk with one voice, IG talk one thing, General I will talk one thing, AGC talk one thing, Troy will talk one thing. So people then feel discouraged. People then feel like, why would we ever go through all of this? Why would we go through? We would go through at the moment. Some persons say, maybe people then just feel, say, maybe we just decide for forget everything. Maybe we just decide for abandon, for throw in the towel. Maybe we decide for step back, leave and make a republic continue for do as they do. In fact, the audio will receive any morning time. We don't even go the rounds. Go to the point of suggesting that this one guy we in the top Ibidi make reference to this Google Earth he be able to track and trace all the fighters there inside Bush. And so you know say La Republique just wait and say make elections pass so that the FI can start take out all those people and say La Republique now an established government. He gets support from all, from everywhere, from the international community. China don't give a republic military equipment. Essentially, we're fighting a lost battle, and our people have been put to untold suffering. So until I hear the thing, it be downcast, and I feel discouraged. But I come back this when I enter office in the morning, I just begin to meditate, meditate God's word, and then. I realize, say, and after that, I find my encouragement. And the reason they give me, I feel like for just maybe share also this message of encouragement. So they make some person we don't hear this kind of discouraging message, they also find strength, find encouragement. And the one thing I want to pass across now say, every time we people them stand up for combat slavery, for combat enslavement, injustice. They need ever undertake na a battle where it will be a walk in the park. So if we start this fight, not expect difficulty. If we start this fight, not expect challenges, then it means we will not be fully measure or assess which we would get into. It means we'll be start for build some house where we know one first leave, one first leave foundation. It means we'll be first start for assess for engage in this process where we will never fully consider which it means. But that will not be the case. You know, if it ever tells slaves, say, make you remain in slavery because a pathway of freedom is a difficult one. From time immemorial, it don't always be the case. For every battle where you fight for deliver yourself from enslavement, you get two categories of people. Number one, the oppressors, when are the people where they maintain the slavery, and then number two, the benefactors, when are people the way that they stay inside, where they be part of the oppressed group, where they don't get a slightly privileged position as a result of the oppression. This category of people are people where Frantz Fanon call them household niggers. And from time immemorial, those two categories of people, they don't always wage war or fight against struggle. So the enter office moment, I say, I just ask myself, I self-reflect. I realize that if one classical example of delivery from slavery within the Bible, that Israel inside Egypt. And I just realized that the first time when Moses received this message, same he was set Israel free from Egyptian slavery, when he actually first go announce for Pharaoh, say, God don't talk for you, say, make you can send the children of Israel them out of Egypt. Pharaoh, his very first reaction, for that very first instant, now for double the people their work. In fact, he gave instruction for his slave masters for Exodus chapter 5. Say, make them go double the work with the people, them make them go double, make them require them, make them submit the same amount of output on a daily basis. They may not provide them supply as before. Put in his own words, say now because say the people then be as they would really ask for freedom. So immediately Moses start this journey for set Israel free from Egyptian slavery. The first reaction may become what the first couple of days now say, life be strong for these people then. Life be hard for these people then. In fact, their labor and their effort then be instead be doubled. If you read from Exodus chapter 5, now just permit me, give me 2 minutes, man, read this passage. So a person will find encouragement from which you have a talk. And it will help me for make the point where I want to make and just send out as a message of hope and encouragement for our people who would go through at the moment. From Exodus chapter 5, verse 17, people will not be, you don't believe in Bible, now just be patient with me. This one is a book of inspiration, and I find inspiration and my purpose this morning in the struggle. So Pharaoh said, lazy, that's what you are, lazy. That's why you keep saying, let us go and sacrifice the Lord. Now get to work. You will not be given any straw, yet you must produce your full quota of bricks. The Israelites foremen realized that they were in trouble when they were told, you are not to reduce the number of bricks required of you for each day. When they left Pharaoh, they found Moses and Aaron waiting for them and said, may the Lord look upon you and judge you. You have made us a stench to Pharaoh and to his officials and have put a sword in his hand to kill us. What people them right now the sentiment where a lot of people then get them on ground zero. They feel say people then where they should on both at home and for diaspora where they don't attempt to make this message for say make will be free from slavery. They don't instead the make and make life be difficult for our people. Now the same reaction the way the Israel begin them after they come out this first attempt at freedom. They start beginning to vex with the leaders the way they don't start to initiate the process of their freedom. Say, if Unani become, start talk the things, say, we'll be in slavery, we'll not forget the punishment we'll get them. If Unani become identify, say, the fact, say, we'll be enslaved and we'll struggle for free ourselves, we'll not find ourselves inside this hardship. So the first reaction, every time you attempt to free yourself from slavery, now a reaction where you go harden your pain, where you go harden the hardship, where you go harden the reality of which you to go through. So now a very standard reaction. And when I talk to a very standard reaction, maybe for minimize which what people did go through. The reaction, unexpected reaction, because of that, now for demonstrate for what people then say, any person where they try for bring about the freedom and the liberation of certain Cameroonians, is attempting to do that which should never have been done. So they go throw out all kinds of smear campaigns. They go look through all kinds of arguments and say, leader, they need only fight now for money. They're there for a white man country. They're picking, then they're fine. They make any other people, they're picking their suffer. They want a standard divide and rule strategy. Now, the same government way, Agbapala and all consortium, they be approached, they made and solve this thing 18 months ago. Now, these same people, then catch them lock up. Now, these same people, then come out for 22nd of September, oh, we can celebrate them as Memorial Day recently. Now, these same people, then arrest our people, then arbitrarily them, transport them, go Yaoundé. Now, these same people, then send helicopter gunships on the 1st of October. May them come begin to shoot our shoot people, then kill them indiscriminately. Now, these same people, them don't burn down villages. Over 70 villages, they be burned down. Now, these same people, them be responsible for the 160, almost 160,000 internally displaced people. Now, these same people, them be responsible for almost the 1,000 refugees, them inside Nigeria. Now, these same people, them be responsible for the fact that the majority of our people, then they abroad, they need to come home because they face the arrest at the airport. Now, these same people, them be responsible for almost 1,000 plus people, they be locked up at the moment, responsible for all the people that they kill them, and they kill them on a daily basis. I don't ask myself the question, say, only Mami, the way they shoot them, so for inside northern and southern zone. And because Mami, they be whole gone, I see picture they come up, where they come up for inside chamber, for Mami, they don't kill them. And because all the Mami, them, all the picking, the way they don't die inside this trouble. And because they're whole gone, now because they don't decide to fight against slavery, how get a justification for the fact, say, we will get a government where you go send people there with guns. They then go kill innocent civilians. When I talk about enemy combatants, when I talk about, say, that they affront people the way they don't take up weapons, the toll, the pressure, the punishment where they put on to the civilian population, how would we explain that one? How would we justify that one? Now, just a standard ploy for make sure, say, may they increase the people that they suffer, may they increase the people their hardship, so that they did turn against the people that don't start talk, say, we suffer, we need to find freedom. Now, a standard divide and rule strategy. And we will be extremely foolish if, in addition to all the enslavement, we'll be enslaved, we agree, may la republic, make a make us will knock our heads against each other. I need to talk, say, what people they need to struggle. I need to talk, say, what leaders. In fact, I've been personally very disappointed with a good number of leaders, because instead for build, instead for assemble, instead for people where they go gather our people, them make a mob, they instead struggle for reassert either their authority, reassert, preserve their place where they occupy them, reassert, preserve their influence over the struggle. At the end of the day, they give ammunition and justification for like the people blame we, so now power will fight, now money will fight. But most of you know, so we not enter this struggle now because of money. Because they fight, and because they know, so the problem will face them, now an existential problem. Now a problem where you get to do the fact, say, we don't try this thing for 56 years, you know, the work. Now, the fact, say, leaders, then they struggle for find synergy as to how to collaborate their effort. It not cancel all the evil when a republic don't do for we are what they still do and what they plan to do at this moment. How you will explain, say, in the midst and in the heat of the struggle, in the heat of the pain with population they face them, they want enter Muto, forgot to stay with their relatives them for safer zones them out of northern southern zone. Now who don't make northern southern zone unsafe? Now we military don't southern zone for the last 2 years. Now who they shoot people there on site without explanation? Now who don't make and make all that papa? That papa where here University of Boya Pekin can't enter their house. They just meet soldiers on soil, shot without asking any question. Now they can't come to the one steady. So we talk say make we put 100 for fine, say make we be liberated. Some people that they complain, say the leaders and be confused, they don't get strategy, they don't know which they want to. No man no go school. I don't always talk to one. No man no go school. For learn how to lead struggle. But all we, in spite of our differences, in spite of our misunderstandings, in spite of all the things that we struggle for fire synergy, we'll be agreed on one thing. The life of the Anglophone in the Cameroon Republic as currently constituted is miserable, and something needs to be done about it.
The majority of us have articulated this with clarity, that we need to revisit the terms of the union that never happened. We need to go back. We need to restore the statehood of Southern Cameroon as was conceived in to every protected territory in the 1960s. With essentially say, so we'll get a problem, we need to fix them. One problem where it arise as a result of difficulties of leaders finding synergy to prosecute the struggle, it may cancel out the merits of the case. So I want to just encourage what people and say, they could not be discouraged. Take into consideration the fact that we currently struggle for finding better coordination. And I need to give that one as an excuse for vindicate the leaders the way they continuously they mess up. They show a total sense of political naivety, total insensitivity to the consequences of their actions. The fact that people then get influence, the fact that they get voice, the fact that the people that listen to them may not get or take them for granted. Every leader will be involved inside this struggle, get a certain sphere of influence, they get a certain set of followers. You need to help any man, you need to help the struggle, but we'll constantly contradict each other in public. When this unity conference for Young Warnish Washington be start, a number of people then put together a proposal. But say, make one realize and say, the realities of the kind of influence that these various people have over fractions and segments of our people requires that we contemplate a kind of collaborative platform that takes into consideration the realities of multilateral governance, where you respect people, their individual identity, respect their sense of how the one contributes to the struggle, but at the same time, a platform where if we do information sharing, if we collaborate in the information dissemination, if we collaborate at the level of diplomacy and our approach to engagement with important stakeholders, and if we at the same time coordinate whatever ground action is taken. That one we can come up at the moment because of people don't ask for unity. Absolute unity that comes with the coalescence of every single group through the emergence of a single leader, it's not going to happen. We are not. Siseko was our best bet at that kind of unity because as an individual, his approach to things was one that assembled. Even in the days of Siseko, there are people who were not too happy with him, but he managed to bring our people together. Now we are sitting at a situation where some people question the legitimacy of other institutions that have been created to prosecute the struggle. Listen, we need people to do what they cannot do. That's the one thing that we don't have ability to do in this instance. So how about we just step back and forge different ways of collaboration? This whole approach of always wanting to be right, always wanting to have your way or the highway, it has not helped us. It is giving ammunition to the Republic to say that we are disorganized. It's giving ammunition to the Republic to say that we don't know what we want. At the end of the day, our people are the ones suffering. Suffering and paying an extremely high price. So my call to all the leaders, I'm talking to Comrade Bo Herbert, I'm talking to Comrade Cho Ayaba, I'm talking to every single frontline leader who is involved in this thing. Let us demonstrate to our people that we are a people who understand the plight and the of our people, and we are prepared to forge ahead with progressive, inclusive collaboration towards the greater good. I address the same call to Comrade Sako and to Comrade Chris Anu. This is what people really get in place, especially make these two individuals that understand, say, leadership na a call to service, maybe a right. You need to take on leadership position because people don't create a platform, afford you the opportunity to provide coordination and leadership. You use them for tantalize every single person we not agree with. Maybe so. It cannot be your way or the highway all the time. At the end of the day, you make us look like we are able to deliver upon that which it is that we have promised our people. We need to do better. We really need to do better. Now, whether the Congress of the people, they do not adopt an approach, say, we don't outline our own strategies, then. We don't present them for people, say, now, so we intend to contribute towards this struggle. Because we don't identify grassroots mobilization and political education as key components. We need to deny any other person their rights to get engaged and involved in the struggle. But we ultimately need to collectively send out a positive message that says, we are aware of the suffering of our people, and we are aware of the price that they are paying. We are not minimizing this pain, and we are wanting to do everything that's in our power to make sure that this struggle is short-lived. That is the kind of message we need to send out. There's no point one person coming out to say one thing and then you go on and contradict. You know, this was not said by your interim government, so disregard it. What is that about? What is that for? It is not necessary. We are not here on an ego contest. Okay? There are people who are dying on a daily basis. If you have a specific offering to put on the table, you do not. I find the cooperative of forging the fight for our liberation moving forward. So while I send out this appeal to all our leaders of all the movements to find a way of minimizing the pain of our people by concentrating upon their value added to this revolution and making that clear to our people so that each person's contribution helps us to move forward. That is what it is. That is what should be. We are not here competing against each other to prove to Southern Cameroonians who can best deliver them. That is not the point. We all have contributions to make. Let us make those contributions in humility and see that we make this struggle to move forward. Now, let me come back to the whole strategy of La République of increasing the pain of our on the leaders. This thing that we don't always be part of every struggle, my people, they make you not be discouraged. The fact said today we'll be free as black people, that not means we don't be under slavery for hundreds and hundreds of years. If you look at the strategy of the slave master in the times of slavery, they will always make him a point every time one single slave attempt to escape. When they catch him, they either execute him publicly or punish him publicly for make sure so they send a message to the rest of the people that say, see what we're trying for, do make no man no effort. Now, a standard practice that. So it only be expected, say, the Republic will use surrogates and agents them for show what people and say, this freedom will be trying to accomplish and so, now a waste of time. Now a thing for other people their struggle. But that one not just a ploy way the struggle for hide the fact saying, now them be the source and the origin of all what single hardship. Which can country would understand the last 56 years? But man, that wrote down this point for how long? For almost how many years? Oh, complain. They don't fix them. As I talk on a car reach today, escape they don't fix that road when you run from Matheson to Bamenda. Now, me, I therefore remind you what we experienced inside this country for the last 56 years, which we will go through for GCE board, which we will go through for even preserve the Anglo-Saxon educational system, which we will go through for even preserve the one university where we don't create and give it. Only for we for even for gain access to medical school. We gain access to the facilities that we enter University of Bamenda. They create University of Bamenda. Can't you appoint me to make a visit the place? Now me and if we remind we why would they fight this fight? No. We not jump inside this thing because things they be there fine. Things were not working. Now the hardship that we are facing at the moment, now only because they don't want to struggle for proof for we say these two will not struggle for free ourselves say. Now, pain upon pain upon pain, it no go work. The issues, the facts are stubborn. We cannot run away from them. And while we may be navigating the pathway of trying to find the most suitable way of getting this freedom, it not means that the fundamental issues them against which we fight, they don't change. They never change. And of course, election no go change that one. Because all election go do, and I don't talk to some of my brother and sister the way they like for believe say election go can bring about trust. All election go do na serity. That machinery there in place, an extremely robust machinery. 7 October will come pass, it will come go. Whether it happen, election happen for inside Northwest and Southwest, or you know, happen Northwest and Southwest, as our people they say make it not happen. The majority of the fact that say will be two provinces out of two regions, we used to be two regions out of 10. By the time that 8 regions they don't vote, La République, the political process doesn't go move forward. So election are a no event, as far as this South of Southern Cameroon struggle be concerned. They go move forward, they go mobilize. They remember the 8 provinces where they never drop, get one day of work since where the thing start. Life could continue. That's why my brother and the phone, they're going to need to realize. That's why some government they go for realize. See, that's where they happen. So they don't kill our people, they mean hundreds and hundreds and hundreds who don't be affected again and again and again. La République and Republicans, they never make, let's say, anything be happen. So we are on our own. When person don't catch you, lock you in slavery. Where you be on your own? Est-ce que you get to negotiate your freedom? Est-ce que you need to get yourself to a point where you tell yourself, say, where this way, the hardship will go through the hardship way, if you avoid it, if you just you don't stay. That one, na lie will need for believer. The men of this struggle stand and they are strong. So the slave master would always want to do things that would make sure that the enslaved person stays enslaved. That's what they are doing at the moment, creating strange militias, sending out propaganda to say that we are confused, sending out propaganda to say we are fighting with each other. Men could not hear those people, they're my people. The bottom line, I say, we don't stand up as one man, we need to secure our freedom. It's not going to be easy. We need to promise you it will be easy, but make the first sign of difficulty, not mean say we throw the towel, we forget about everything, we don't struggle, so we fight for, and then go back and tell the say, I beg, when I forgive you, we won't continue to do our slave, anything we don't fight for. And the slave master will always be a resistance. So I want to give a message of hope. Make you understand, say, the first thing will always happen after you declare a struggle for freedom. I say the person where they oppress you, go fight for maintain your oppression. And I want to encourage our people to say, make you persevere. There is light at the end of the tunnel. In the last 24 months, we don't accomplish, which will not be accomplished in the last 56 years. We don't make a people to understand, say, we'll be determined and resolute to accomplish the freedom, the restoration, and forget the different states. We don't tell people to say, never and never again shall we be, are we going to be the Abamenda. Never and never again we'll go be Jambutuku. Never and never again we'll go back to this model where the exercise oppressive colonization over we, they say the conquer inside war. No, we'll start off this relationship as a relationship of two equals sitting across the table. If we are going to continue to coexist as neighbors, then we need to start treating each other like equals. The fact that they get firepower and military spread over our territory, not give them the right for be the one destiny. Because the same United Nations provisions, the way it give statehood to a republic, recognizing the borders secured at independence, and the same United Nations provisions, the way it give we recognition as a people with the rights to self-determination. We're not going to negotiate that one because our oppressors, them at the moment, get firepower. And I want to address this Ojoe, this person sent out this morning. But once that this thing, wouldn't be ignorant of the fact, say, that the Republic get international support in France, the Republic international support in critical stakeholders, them, where they be determined for say their interests and be secured in Cameroon. Our intention of engage those stakeholders, them, because our enslavement to the Republic not get nothing to do with those stakeholders, their interests. The conceptualization of what development would put them forward, we need to build them based exclusively on natural resources. Because natural resources are the one thing where the interests of stakeholders would essentially advocate for the right to live free and articulate development that meets the aspiration of our people. We don't need to go secure permission from France or from America for make sure say what people then get the kind of hospitals and way it could give make them live their life with dignity. We need for secure permission from China to make sure what people then get the kind of educational system where it could give them the education, prepare them for being 21st century citizens. We need for go secure permission from France or from all these people then to make sure say we get the kind of legal system where it could give you access to justice, access to the right to live a decent life. In fact, this same international community where we talk say they support the Republic, so now then the complaint so will be migrate, would you come flop their country? Look at how Britain will break it. And the vets will come flop for our country. But we'll tell us our own country. So that we don't need for the die every day in the Mediterranean because of the struggle for go abroad. Then some people they want things say the people they not go see say a good thing. No. Make we choose which narrative we want to believe. It is to the interest of the European Union that migration is stemmed. It's the interest of the United States of America that migration is brought up. It's a big problem now in the Mediterranean Sea. They're trying to fund and sponsor Libya to stop Africans from going to Europe. They're trying to fund and make sure that a big issue in those Western countries. Britain is trying to close its border out of the European Union because it feels overwhelmed. Now, as citizens that are coming out of these African countries, we are saying to those international communities that good and fine, we want to fix our own countries. So do not stand. If you're not going to help us, don't fight us. A very simple message. We're not fighting for our right to gain access to your countries. We are fighting for our right to fix our own countries by calling our leaders to account, by having a citizens' conversation that tell the people that this is the kind of country that we want to be for us. It's inalienable rights. For living, it's the kind of society we want to construct them to ourselves. And every person we don't mess up this thing up to this point, we need to let them understand, say, no, a definition of insanity for continue to do the same thing and they expect a different result. There is nothing sinister about it. The fact that the people, the way they almost preserve privilege, they fight against privilege, it not mean say the fundamental argument, they don't change, it never change. No. To make our people then be patient. The merit of our argument then be solid. The freedom we want them, maybe accident. Nobody's going to fight for Bobby president like Southern Cameroon. No. We are fighting for the creation of a society that is at least a minimal reflection of our abilities. We know that we can do better. We can build better roads, build better hospitals, build better airports, build better infrastructures, have more robust legal systems, have a better managed health system, have a better. It is inside of us. Your children, both back home and abroad, have acquired the skills, the knowledge, and the necessary know-how for the last almost 50-something years. Give us that country, we are going to manage it and manage it way better than what it is at the moment. We'll transform it to be a Singapore in the Gulf of Guinea, where people from all over the world will be proud to come and visit. That is the essence. We want to accomplish it without having to fire a single gunshot. But the people that we're dealing with, they are deaf and dumb. They are not listening to us. So now a very basic request. We want to say this message we want to send across, a message of encouragement. Make we not lose hope. Every struggle will go through different seasons and phases and way we go meet hardship. We go, you know, there's no point. We'll feel like say difficulty. We'll feel like say things will be hard. But make we press on. Because we don't see with clarity the promised land will be ahead of us. We'll get a clear sight vision of which we want accomplishment. We don't know how we will get there. We'll get not only we'll resolve with will and with determination and the interests of our people at heart. And we know so as we continue to organize ourselves systematically, we will ultimately find reasonable partners in the international community who would find the merit of our case and would stand with us to advance our struggle. So my people then, a luta continue, the battle continue. Make we not be discouraged. Make we not give up. Make we not give in to these lies the way they want make them all knock our head against each other. We don't oversuffer. We don't suffer quietly for the last 50-something years. Now we don't stand talk, say, make things then change. Make the people then don't just increase what suffer. For sure, say, make sure so we'll be slave and slave for them forever. Now, times we will need for stand, be strong, be encouraged more than ever before. Stand by each other. All the people that don't die, all the people that don't already pay an ultimate price, they never die now for nothing. They die for a just cause. They die because they want to make we live a better life. They die because they believe, they dare for dream, believe in this hope, in this dream. Oh, to communicate to them, say we can do better and we can live better. And that is a hope worth dying for. It's a hope and a dream worth being, giving our all for. Maybe a thing will be discouraged at this moment. So make we not be discouraged. 22nd of September, they come up. 1st October, they come up. Now, it turns this for we for remember, for remind ourselves. What is this struggle going to be all about? I tell for you to remember all the people that they be locked up inside prison. We go won't give up now, say, make it wait to happen for other people that don't be locked up. We won't give up now, say, who's that justice going to come up for other people that don't kill them? We won't give up now, say, all the people that don't sacrifice up to this point. They don't sacrifice and sacrifice for waiting. I beg. It is hot. We not say it is hot. They make we not give up. Maybe time this will give up. Make we find strength, find encouragement, encourage each other. Get our acts together, bring adjustments where adjustments must be made. Then we must stay focused, resolute, set our eyes on the goal, and continue to press on, you know, towards the accomplishment of our objective. Continue to press on towards the accomplishment. Now, another says need to come. We want to stay safe. We don't want useless loss of life, but we don't want compromise. We don't want to sell ourselves short from the thing that we activate for, the change that we want, the transformation that we want to see. The difference that we want to bring to the lives of our people, the future that we want to prepare for our children's children. We want to make sure, say, the battles that we fight them today, make we begin and know we can fight the same battle. Make we leave them a better Southern Cameroon, something to be proud of. Now, finally, take this opportunity to address myself to all the compadre bourgeoisies, all these household niggas, where they don't make them their mission for fight for preserve the system. I want to say we're be on the wrong side of history. I want to say we're be on the wrong side of history. No people who have stood up to fight against their people have ended up succeeding. It shall not happen. Because of the justice and the merit of the cause that we are fighting, you are fighting against your history. You are fighting against your history, and you are going to go down in history as being one of the obstacles that we needed to overcome in order to secure the freedom that we aspire for. For obstacles we shall overcome. We shall overcome you. We don't suffer for 56 years. We don't see better, worse days. We don't fight worse enemies. Maybe a Tangaji will not overcome you. Maybe a Kimapachi will overcome you. Maybe all these different elites, the way they enjoy the day in bed, the government will not overcome it. We will overcome Una. Because the will of the people to secure freedom is greater than the benefits that you are deriving from being in part of this government. Now, why that did you see when France was not calling people a capitalist household nigger? Now, because the people them now slaves away, they need to stay inside farm. Instead, they be good behaved, they be well behaved. So, slave masters, they ever go take them, bring them inside house, give them better clothes, and they always chop from the slave master in crumbs. So that when slave master don't finish take lunch and supper, when they can't clear table, they get at least some more fresh meat, fresh milk, and proteins them. Chop away their own slave brother. Where they inside farm, they need supper. So when the slave or the inside farm, they struggle with talk say, we'll be enslaved, we need to free ourselves. That is very same better treated slaves, and they will call talk say, make we no do ways with the struggle for you because you're being up with and plenty suffer. No. We are not going to fit, stand in the will and the way of the people. So my people, scope now hope. Hope means say times of despair go day. That make we not lose heart. Make we not give up. Make we be encouraged. Make we remain focused. Make we remind ourselves of the reason why we engaged in this struggle in the first place. Make we remind ourselves of the price that all the people who have died so far have paid. Make we remind ourselves of the fact say, we may be at any point think say it will be easy. We may be at any point take for granted say this thing will come without a price. It's coming at a price. The thing we can do is minimize the price. But to say that we're going to secure our freedom without having to pay a price would not to be being realistic to ourselves. So patience, perseverance, we are not where we used to be. We have come a long way. We have secured our gains. We need to close ranks. We need to mobilize ourselves better. We need to organize ourselves better. But the fundamental essence of why we are involved in this struggle has not changed. So our resolve to continue to make a difference should not change. Aluta continua, Amandla, freedom shall come to Southern Cameroons, and we shall be a free people that have secured the lives that we aspire for ourselves and our children. Short live the struggle. God bless the Southern Cameroonians and Ambazonian Republic.